Well, guys, and good morning. Sorry, I just woke up, folks. I'm gonna tell you a little story. It's about my when I discovered the Unart. And I've started till the end. Alright. It all started in 2007. I discovered DeviantArt by looking up Tails pictures. And I was like, I wonder. I'm interested in doing this. Well, a year later in February or so, I joined. Basically, what started is, started taking pictures and stuff. That's what I'm watching a lot of people then. One of my oldest friends is known as, Trixie Prower, now as Speedy Alchemist. She's one of the first people I met. At first, I was shy, but pretty much got used to when I introduced myself to everyone finally. Let's see. Well, let's just say I think drawing was gonna be my thing. That's until in December of 2008 is when I created my first three stories. Tales of Nightmare Aftermath, The Next Best Thing Aftermath, and Merrick Kato Rescue Mission 1. Those were the very first three stories I did. That's when I realized stories are my primary forte. A little later on, the three stories were created until I created my first six OCs. Merrick, Minix, Ronan, Bojan, Dylan, and my very first female OC, Misha. When people actually discovered my stories and whatnot, and first see meet Merrick, Misha, everyone, and including Misha, let's just say some people fell in love with Merrick. Reason why? Well, if you may well ask, Merrick and Tails became a thing as brothers in a way. Later on, I changed up and made Merrick as Tails' big cousin. And that pretty much stuck with me the whole way. Let's just say the only two people that's well known so far is Merrick and Misha. And Misha being the cutest one. But yeah, I digress. Alright, around in 2009. Well, 2009 is where I met any of the Skunk Hog along with others and stuff. Let's just say along the way I met up with a lot of users then. Did lots of stories and crossovers and etc. That's when I had my first time of role-playing the first time, or RP for short. Met lots of people in my way. And, I requested a lot of pictures with American Tales in it. So, yeah. I That's until I got word that the Tales of Nightmare Aftermath story gotten so famous, people actually literally did fan art on that, as well as comics and stuff. But I'll get to that briefly whenever I can, when I get to that point. All right, 2010. That's the year when I met Sadie, Jack, Seminator, Minty, and others. And Clune and Chrono. Those were the best times of my life there. And not to mention fan art of them was in it altogether there. And I did a couple of pieces with Sadie and a little bit from Minty and some from Chrono. That's until 2011 arrives, and well, let's just say over the years and whatnot, I kind of lose touch with friends, which is very well true. Around 2011 or so is when things changed from my friends' side. For example, you know what, I'd rather not talk about it. Too many memories that are bad or need to be left behind. 2011 was actually a rough one in some way, at least I think. The reason why I say rough, because that's when I don't remember much what happened in 2011, but I did meet some new friends along the way. Like, if you saw my vent video when I was talking about Savvy, that was one of the friends that I met up and broke her off with. Oh yeah, 2011 is when I met Jeannie Prower, 19th the first time. Along with others. Our first RP rodeo happened in summer of 2011, I think. As far as I remember. Let's just say I stuck around with Jeannie Prower 19 from 2011 to 2013 and such. Well, 2012 was actually, we thought, the year when the world ends. I was like, you're right. But yeah, I think 2012 was one of my active years, one of my productive years, so to speak. Making a lot of stories. Oh yeah, and 2012 is when I started asking permission for theirs if I can post pictures of them, my characters and whatnot. Plus requests and stuff. And that's when I realized I was becoming well known over time. Then came 2013, is when I found out when Jeannie Prower 19 was leaving DeviantArt completely. I was saddened to hear her go, but at least I have her email and such. Well, after Jeannie Prower left, is when I stuck around with my friend Rose. And over time in 2013 to 2014, around 2014 or so, is when I heard that my grandma Kathleen was diagnosed with lung cancer. It dawns me how and why that happened. But when 2015 began, around late 2015. Late January 2015 is when Grandma died. I was upset and saddened. Upset and saddened to hear her pass away. A couple of days after that is when Sir Elliot, also known as KD0706, the maker of Moments with Heavy, also died from leukemia. 2015 was actually a rough one for me. Hold on, I'll be right back, folks. That's pretty much an important call. Hello? Hello? This is he. Sorry about that. I accidentally stepped on my cat's tail. Sorry. Yes, this is he. Baby, by the way. Okay, I'm back, folks. Sorry about that. That was Miss Jessica from CCDS, so sorry about that. That was pretty much gonna get stuck in here. But anyways, where was I? As I said, 2015 is actually one of my rough ones because, first Uncle Joe died from a heart attack. Next, after that, Kathleen died. The next is when Sir Elliot, the makers of Moments with Heavy, died a couple days after that. So yeah, I was mourning my loss. That's until sometime in February or March of 2015. Is when I met my friend Shona. Let's just say I received a picture from her when she fell in love with my OC Aqua the Terrain Fox. Oh yeah, also the year before before meeting Shona is when I met my friend Fang980. Let's just say I found out a story he made and took offense to that, and we became friends after that, after he made some changes. But yeah. Okay, what was I? Oh yeah, 2015. March 2015. It's when I met Dragon Wolf. It's when I met my friend Draco for the very first time. And also introduced me to Kit Prower and everyone. Excuse me. Sorry about that. Got my little facts confused. Mixed up. March is when I met SonicFan1345, also known as my friend Shona. She made a picture of Aqua, the Terrain Fox, and that's when I got interested in doing requests with her. Our first RP was first RP was about when Aqua met Shona and her adopted brother for the first time. Let's just say 2015 is one of my crazy ass years, because that's when I did lots of RPs with Shona. Oh yeah, also later in April is when I met Draco for the first time. And by the way, in case you're wondering, these are my current friends that I met and stuck around with for a long while. But I digress. Bane, Dragonwolf, or known as Draco, had characters like Draco, Jericho, Kit Prower, etc. Let's just say I actually fell in love with Kit Prower when I saw a picture for the first time. So yeah. Oh yes, at the same time in 2015 is when I met my adopted younger sister, Vivi, for the first time. Helped her and saved her life from my suicide. Became friends after that. Then came Tom Todd, which I actually met in, Tom, if you're seeing this, can you comment below and let me know what year and day we met each other the first time? Because I can't remember. I actually can't remember crap because, you know, I just woke up and everything, but yeah. So if you're watching this, Tom, can you tell me what year and day we met, clean month? Thank you. What was I? Ah, yes. Well, Tom Todd 774 and I did not start RPing until like 2016 and whatnot. And yeah. Speaking of 2016, that was actually the final year of my DeviantArt career, DeviantArt month, DeviantArt journey. All right, 2016. Celebrated New Year's with friends. Celebrated Valentine's Day, St. Patrick's Day, and what else? Oh yeah, 2016 is when I met my friend Jesse, also known as Roxas the Cat. He was the last friend I ended up meeting on DeviantArt before I got banished, which was during the summer, so to speak. Now then, after I did my 2016 9/11 tribute. Now, around my dad's birthday, after I got off from work, when I got home from supper at Applebee's for dad's birthday, got a message from Draco that my DA got banished. I checked and, well, lo and behold, they got banished. I was highly upset, and when Philip got home is when I broke down crying. Let's just say after getting banished was a rough couple days. And a week later, or a month or so later, is when I came to resolve. My brain, my heart, My mind and my heart is telling me that this was actually the end. As in, it was time for me to end my career on DA anyways and move on to another site. Until the day when Hurricane Matthew came around is when my resolve came around to realize that I'm actually finished with DeviantArt for good this time. I think of returning. That's until my friend Clash told me that some of the admins are highly corrupted. And to realize to my realization, everyone, all the admins, became corrupted in their updated rules and stuff, causing lots of innocent people to be banished. Isn't it people such as my friend Sasha and Train Man and whatnot and lots more? When I was talking with Bridge on Skype or on FA, which is where I'm currently at now, he was glad that I was actually now out of DeviantArt. And to be honest, I have to agree with Bridge on this one. DeviantArt itself was actually deteriorating over time. And just to be brutally honest here, folks, I'm glad to be out of that website for good. Okay, corrupt the website, and, that's when my resolve is now completely sane there. In short of this story, I'm actually giving myself closure and such, which is why I'm telling this. And because of all the crap happening on DeviantArt, I've decided and reconsider not returning to DeviantArt. So yeah, I'm sorry folks, but what happened just happened, and what is done is done. Now, if you wonder where I am at now, it's Firm Fanity now. That's my new base of operations, which is right here. It's right here, folks. This is where I belong. Let's just say, for now, in my life's mission, reconnect with my friends on various websites like Skype and Google Hangouts. But yeah, as I said from my friend Bridge, I was glad to be out of DeviantArt. That's when I found out my resolve. So with that said, I've now given my own closure. And also that a heavy reminder that I will not do anything like this again. But, yeah, just a heavy reminder and a heavy lesson. So with that, I end my DeviantArt story right here. Began at late February of 2008. DeviantArt journey has ended around September 28th. 2016. My name is Jared Allen Caruso, aka Ronhunt097, aka Merrick Channel. I will leave you. I will leave this video right here for all of you to see of my DeviantArt story. This is Merrick Channel out. P.S. Stay tuned for the next video, because I'll be giving you what's going to happen in September and the rest of the fall months. Later, guys. Merrick Channel, over and out. Have a good day, folks.